Every once in a while, I come across YouTube videos showing tips and circuits you probably should not recreate. But despite their questionable quality, these videos have millions of views. Here's one example. It shows you how to make a lithium-ion battery charger with an indicator. It has 700,000 views, 21,000 likes, so it's probably good, right? And here is another one showing the same circuit. This video has over 4 million views. And comments range from "this is genius" to "this will burn your house down." There is nothing wrong with sharing your work online, but the problem with both of these videos is that they are misleading, to say the least. But let's build the circuit anyway, and I'll show you what is wrong with it. Here are the parts we need. Two LEDs, one red, one green. One silicon diode, and a 1 kilo ohm resistor. If you follow the steps in the video, you will end up with the following circuit. I've only added a switch on the input side to simulate the charger being plugged in and removed. And here I have the same circuit built on a breadboard. I'm using a different diode, a 1N4004 instead of a 4007, but that will not make any difference. When I connect my 18650 battery, the green LED turns on. This is my breadboard power supply, which is set to 5 volts. When I plug in the charger, the green LED turns off and the red one turns on. Indeed, the battery is now charging. It is not charging very quickly, but we do have some current flowing. But here is the first issue I have with these videos. They lead you to believe that the LEDs indicate when the battery is done charging. In reality, the green LED only comes on when the charger is removed. Notice how this charger from the video is plugged into something that looks like an extension cord. So this part of the circuit is next to useless. In fact, it is currently draining the battery, which is far from full. All I need to achieve the same charging function is a diode in series with the battery. But this is still a very bad way of charging a lithium-ion battery. There is a limit to how much voltage these batteries can be subjected to, and it is always stated in the datasheet. Typically, it is around 4.2, 4.3 volts, and if the battery sees a voltage higher than this, it may be easily damaged. There is nothing in this circuit to limit the maximum voltage other than the diode and maybe the resistance in the wires. When the diode is in series with the battery, it creates a voltage drop of around 0.7, 0.8 volts. So instead of 5 volts from the charger, the battery should see around 4.2 volts, at least in theory. But in practice, a charger may supply slightly more. Like right here, I'm measuring 5.2 volts. And if I replace the battery with a capacitor, the circuit charges it up to 4.5 volts. In other words, this circuit can damage your battery by overcharging it. It will take a very long time because the circuit charges the battery very slowly, but it is possible. But it gets worse. Let's assume you decide to use a different diode. This is a Schottky diode. It looks very similar to the silicon diode from the circuit, but it has a lower forward voltage. This means you can overcharge the battery to an even higher voltage. So how do you charge a lithium-ion battery safely? Well, I suggest you just get one of these tiny modules. Links are in the video description if you want one. They are very cheap, they fit on a breadboard, and the built-in protection chip prevents both overcharge and over-discharge. Also, they follow the proper charging process for a lithium-ion battery and have LED indicators that actually do what they are supposed to. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like. And consider checking out my Patreon page, where I share more interesting stuff about electronics and making YouTube videos in general. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.